Check me later. I need some bread, babies. Here's the deal, McNeil, so bot me your lobes. Dearly beloved, we have stepped upon this wailing scene to unite these chicks and these cats in the swinging little number of matrimony. Do you likely male prospectives? Take these two lovely ladies to have, to hold, to lay a little bread upon, and generally dig till their silver threads bear heavy split ends?
Sins believing, so it's a babble.
And do you lovely foxy ladies take these two button bennies to be your swinging partners in good times, bad times, New York Times, and the National Enquirer?
Hold tight, I'm coming down the line. I'm a seafood mama, don't waste no time.
Then with the power vested in me by Murray the K Submarine Race Watcher Society, I pronounce you locks and bageled, window and framed. It's crazy rhythm all the same. And now with the newlyweds, embrace your spouses.
Sweet and candy, and candy's sweet on me.
She understands me. My understanding candy,
and candy's always handy. Candy, I'm making mine, all mine.
Candy, I call my sugar candy, because I'm sweet, so sweet on candy.
Yeah. Ocean City, straddling the majestic canyons of Hollywood, is the persuasive percussions of the Manhattan Transfer. And their comedy guest, that devilish rogue, Mr. David Brennan.
This is Leslie, choosing a Lifesavers flavor.
I would like some Lifesavers, please.
You want a boost?
That one.
Fancy fruits?
No, the red one.
Cherry Lifesavers?
No, what's that?
Tangerine.
That's my favorite.
No, I'll take it.
Good.
22 delicious flavors are why everyone likes choosing Lifesavers.
Mr. Lifesavers,
a part of living.
I made this office something to be proud of, and now it's my turn.
Be good to yourself, it's important to do, so be good to yourself, there's only one you.
Cutting calories is one way to be good to yourself, but don't cut down on flavor. Tab gets its taste from the Coca-Cola Company, and that's about as good as you can get.
Be good to yourself with Tab.
Hi, Freddy. You know, tonight there will be two of us. My date should be here any minute now. I don't know what he looks like, but he's very mysterious. I think he's with a CIA or the FBI or something, because he won't tell me what he does for a living. So say nothing and just, you know, act natural. Oh, dance, you sinners, dance. This is the real New York. People who know that just because the world is going down the tubes, that's no reason to let your foxtrot go to the dogs. People think we wasps don't care just because we don't expose ourselves to one of their funky ethnic groups. Well, I've heard the wail of the black man calling out for the right to stand there just because he's got to be himself. Sammy Davis Jr. said that yesterday on The Tonight Show. But two of the people who most inspire me are Gandhi and Chavez. You know, I've read that both of those heroic figures would go on month-long fasts, even though they didn't have to lose weight. I actually considered spending a summer working side by side in the fields with the migrant farm workers, but I sunburn so easily. Really, I would be out there every day. I'd work with them from dawn until they left to dress for dinner. Despite what those who are prejudiced say, wasps are aware of what's going on in this world, and we do have feelings. My charity efforts have saved many an Angora cat. I mean, when one of those New York liberals, and you know the type, Afro permanent tinted glasses, polyester leisure suit, puka necklace, gold chains, the kind of man I personally never notice. When one of those liberals says that wasps can't get angry over social injustice, I get so mad I could shout, "Oh, fudge!" Pardon my French. Are you ready for this? I actually had a date with a man of the colored persuasion. I don't know whether he was Apache or Puerto Rican. All those aliens look alike to me. I must confess, there's something about foreign men that intrigues me. Romance, mystery, Marseille, Tangiers, Morocco. When Pepe Lamoco sang, "For every man there's a woman," in my heart I cried, "I want to be that woman." 2 hours late. Still 2 hours late. I know. Maybe I'll leave now, so when he does show up, he'll be the one who gets stood up. Why should I always be the one? I think I want another drink.
Something cool. I'd like to order something cool. It's so warm.
Thank you. 1950. Levi Strauss invented the toughest pants the West had ever known. Levi's blue jeans.
We put a little blue jean in everything we make.
Today, we're threading that same blue jean spirit through every shirt, pant, and jacket we make.
We put a little blue jean in everything we make.
In everything we make.
Levi's.
When you buy a seat on a bus, you have several choices, the best of which is Trailways. It's a better seat. It's all fabric. It reclines a full 145 degrees. It has an exclusive adjustable headrest with wings for support when you nap. Plus, every Trailways seat has a footrest. Like I said, it's a better seat, and better yet, it's the same price. Next time, take a Trailways. For my money, it's the best bus going.
It was winter in Manhattan, falling snowflakes filled the air. The streets were covered with a film of ice. But a little simple magic that I've learned to love so well changed the weather all around just within a trice. I bought you violets for your ferns, and it was spring for a while, remember. I bought you violets for your ferns, and it was April in that December. The snow
Hey Dougie, when you come out here on this stage, are you ever nervous?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean you're out here in front of all these people. Don't you get nervous?
What people?
Dougie, there are 20 million people, maybe 30 million people out there watching. Right now.
Oh boy. Wow. I'm a star.
Star Doug?
Yeah.
Listen, Dougie.
Yeah.
There's something I've always wondered about ducks.
What's that?
Well, how do you tell the little girl ducks from the little boy ducks?
Lipstick.
Lipstick?
Yeah.
When do the girls, I'm assuming it's the little girl ducks, when do the little girl ducks start wearing lipstick, Dougie?
When you're 16.
16?
Yeah.
Well, how do you tell them apart before they're 16?
Pantyhose.
Pantyhose?
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
Well, when do they start wearing pantyhose?
When they're 14.
Dougie, how do you tell them apart before they're 14?
What's the difference in orange? An orange peony can assist you.
Oh. Dougie, there's one thing I... Dougie, there's one thing I never could understand.
Yeah, what's that?
How do ducks eat worms?
Very fast. You have to eat them like spaghetti.
What kind of worms do you like?
Little ones.
Uh-huh. Why? Why little ones?
They don't have any bones.
I see.
Yeah.
That makes sense. That's why I like bananas.
Bananas. That's funny.
Yeah, thank you, Dougie. Listen, Dougie.
Yeah.
Right now you're being real good, but have you ever been bad?
Oh, yeah. Once.
Only once?
Yeah.
Amazing. What did you do that one time?
Well, when I was three, I tried to swim across the lake all by myself.
Personally, I think that's pretty ambitious. Well, what was so bad about it?
Well, Mommy was afraid that I would get lost.
Yeah, mothers are like that. That's what my mother thought when I was coming out to Hollywood.
Yeah. No.
Here I am, Mom. Where were you supposed to be?
Oh, I was supposed to be in the nest.
Well, how did she find you?
She could hear me.
She could hear you swimming across the lake?
No, screaming. Mommy, Mommy, I'm lost! I'm lost! Mommy, help!
Oh, Dougie.
You are silly.
Dougie, canaries and nightingales and mockingbirds, they all sing. Is that right?
Yes, Tim. That's right.
Why don't ducks sing?
They do.
Ducks sing?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay, let's hear you sing.
Yeah, get down.
Get down?
Yeah.
Okay. One, two, three, four. Oh, my God, I'm a frog. E-I-E-I-O. And all this frog, I'm a duck. E-I-E-I-O. When you drink right here, drink right there. You drink, you drink, you drink, you drink.
So, go ahead.
There's more.
Yeah. There's more.
Homecooked, you know it's in the bag.
Yeah. Pork chops and gravy. Pork chops and gravy. Pork chops and gravy. I want a pork chop at Charlie with some cornbread. Pork chops and gravy. Pork chops and gravy. Pork chops and gravy. I want a pork chop at Charlie with some cornbread.
Fried chicken and lima beans, baby. If you get a pork chop,
you'll be in the groove, yeah. Pork chops and gravy,
oh.
Pork chops and gravy,
oh, really, really.
Pork chops and gravy. I want a pork chop and chocolate with some cornbread.
Fried chicken
in the bag.
Corn on the cob
in the bag.
Home cookies
in the bag.
I want a pack of pizza mama with the frying pan. Bacon and beans
in the bag.
Chicken fricassee
in the bag.
Blackout beans
in the bag.
I want a pork chop and chocolate with some cornbread. Bread it in, bread it in, bread it in, in. Papa told the lads on, Papa told the lads on. Candy
in the bag.
Blackberry jam
in the bag.
Fried ham
in the bag.
I want a pork chop and chocolate with some cornbread.
Do da do da do da da do da do da do da da do da do da do da da do da do da do da do da do da do da 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 do da.
One more rib a duty, we'll get him, Mama.
Skip the bop, bop, baby, grease of leg, bloop to skid away. Pork chops and gravy, pork chops and gravy, pork chops and gravy. I want a
on a pork chop, a chowder with some cornbread.
Pork chops and gravy.
Pork chops and gravy.
I really need some
pork chops and gravy. I'm on a pork chop, a chowder with some cornbread. Da da da. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. I'm on a pork chop, a chowder with some cornbread.
There's Mini Wheats a-coming.
Oh, they're all American cereals, made from natural wheat. Oh, they're crisp and toasted, sugar and cinnamon, frosted Mini Wheats.
They're neat little mini biscuits,
topped with plain frosting or brown sugar cinnamon.
Plum tasty cereal,
part of a good nutritious breakfast.
Sure is.
Oh, they're all American sugar and cinnamon, frosted Mini Wheats.
From Kellogg's.
As the weather gets warmer, your refrigerator's opened and closed a lot more often. That's the time to put in a fresh box of Arm & Hammer baking soda. Baking soda actually absorbs odors caused by warm weather foods, like cantaloupe, watermelon, peaches, broccoli, cheese, fish. Leaves your refrigerator fresher and cleaner smelling, even in the hottest weather. And pour the old box down the drain to help keep it sweet smelling through the warm weather, too.
Once again, it's time for the station break. We'll return in but a moment. Ta-ta-ta.
Catch the brightest stars on CBS.
Let's discuss this quietly and calmly.
Richard Castellano as a widower raising his family alone. Joe and Sons.
Tuesday, starting this fall on CBS.
Motor Trend called it the best style car of 75. Road and Track called it the best sports car under $5,500. We call it the Fiat X19.
Tomorrow only, during Sears Red Tag Sale, save 10 to 40% on many items for your family, your home, and your car. That's tomorrow only at Sears.
Campbell's Pork and Beans now has a richer, heartier, more flavorful sauce. Just the way you like it.
Nice going, Campbell.
Channel 2, New York.
Musicians and camera crew, take a five. Ladies and gentlemen in the studio, we're going to take a break before we start the second half of the show. And while we're waiting, we might as well have a few laughs. Please welcome Mr. David Brenner. Let's hear it for David Brenner, please.
Thank you. Can you hear me? I got a little bit of a cold. You hear okay? Because I have a cold. I'm the first one in America to get the flu. I am. I could tell you when the epidemic's coming. I mean it. The bug gets off the boat from Hong Kong and New York. He looks up in a phone book. I'm still living in Manhattan. Comes over on the subway. Doesn't touch anyone. Nice hanging on a strap. And I was thinking, I was sick 3 days. 3 days, and I was feeling sorry for myself. And I started thinking there are worse things in life than getting the flu. You can catch terrible things from people. You know that. And I start, not that. And I start thinking, wouldn't it be horrible if you could catch terrible things from people like, suppose you could catch being fat. You know what I mean? You're walking down the street nice and thin, you bump into a fat guy, boom, excuse me, right? It could happen, it could. I remember when I was a little kid, I bumped into a guy with a big nose, I'll never forget that. But I don't feel bad about having a big nose. You know who I feel sorry for? I feel sorry for short people. I do. Oh, I do. It must be frightening to wake up in the morning and see your feet right here. And you know what really frightened me? You know, I had a pilot coming out here. You know I'm afraid to fly. And let me tell you why, because people think I'm superstitious. I'm afraid because I was in an emergency landing. And I knew we were in trouble before anyone when I saw a wing go by the window with no plane on it. And then I heard, my luck, right under my feet, I hear, you know, we're up in the air about 2 hours. I looked down, what is that? And there was a fellow sitting next to me. He must have been stoned or something. I turned to him, a guy about my age. I said, do you hear that noise? He said, yeah, we were hit by a truck. And we made an emergency landing. And you know, people are dumb. We're really dumb. The plane blew a tire when we landed. and it skidded. And when it finally came to a stop, everyone applauded. And I thought, what would they do if we crash, boo? Oh, bad landing, bummer, boo. But I'll tell you, the pilot, now listen to what the pilot does on this flight. We're flying 2 hours nonstop New York to LA. The pilot comes out, and I hate when they do this. He comes out for his visitation. I hate that. You know, he walks around saying hello to people. That's crazy. I mean, that's like being in the back of a car and the driver suddenly climbs over the seat to talk to you. What the fuck? Now he comes over and he recognizes me and he says, oh, David Brenner. And then you know what he says to me? We're flying 2 hours nonstop New York to LA. You know what he said to me? He scared me so much. He says, where are you going? Where am I going? But we all say dumb things. Everyone says dumb things. Like, you ever had the phone ring? You pick it up, you say hello, and someone says, oh, you're home. No, this is the bathtub. David went out about 5 minutes ago. My mother called. My mother's a sweetheart. She doesn't mean to be funny. My mother called to tell me that a distant cousin, 10 times removed, passed away. And on the phone, she says to me, David, we're going to give him a decent burial. And I thought, what's an indecent burial? What, do you leave his arm out of the ground? It's like I heard two men reminiscing. They were from the same hometown. They had not seen each other in 40 years. They were talking about what road was there and what changed in the building. And then one of them said to the other one, he said, last week we buried Harry Sills. It was horrible. And the other one said, oh, did Harry die? No, we just buried him. That's what's so horrible. He was in a suit and tie. We were in a lousy mood. I'll tell you the dumbest. You want to hear the dumbest thing anyone ever said to me? First, I'll tell you the old dumbest, because I have a new dumb. This is the old dumb. And then it used to be the new dumb. It became the old dumb. Okay. The old dumb. I was waiting for a bus on 3rd Avenue in New York City. And a man comes over to me and says, how long ago did the last bus pass? Now, do I look like the kind of idiot lets the first bus go by, looks at his watch, and waits to get on the second? Now, I'll tell you the dumbest. And this happened to me twice within a week and a half. I couldn't believe it. Twice. I'm sitting in New York City. I'm sitting on a subway. And I'm sitting on a newspaper. And a man came over. He said, you reading that paper? Now, the first time it happened, I don't know what to say to the guy. The second time, I was ready. I said yes, stood up, turned the page, and sat down.
Thank you very much, David. That was terrific. We're all set to go, ladies and gentlemen. Stand by, Tim. Here we come.
It's always a pleasure to introduce a new musical experience to America. Recently, we brought you a vocal group that caused such an incredible sensation. Well, there just aren't words to describe what went down. Our switchboard was swamped with calls from fans, agents, and other deviants. The reaction was so tremendous, we have been forced to fly them back at terrific expense for another appearance. So here they are, the group you pleaded to see, the group you killed to see, the group you need to see. The indestructible Guido and the Flat Tones.
Out of sight, out of mind, so the story goes. You forgot I exist. My broken heart knows. Out of sight, out of mind.
forget if I could, but my heart is blind. You are gone out of sight, but not out of my mind. Out of sight,
out of sight,
but not out of my mind.
We did it before, and we can do it again. This time, it's a nationwide sale from Chrysler Corporation.
Terrific, Joe.
Okay. This time, you can get $300 cash back on new 1975 full-size Chryslers, Dodge Monacos, and Plymouth Grand Furies. $300 back on the cars with room and luxury. So come on down to your participating Dodge or Chrysler Plymouth dealers for their nationwide sale.
We did it before. We'll do it again.
Aren't you glad?
Glad is what happens when you use Dial.
Turn it on.
You just can't buy a better deodorant soap.
Let it splash.
Or one that lasts longer.
Feel it fresh when you use Dial. Feel it clean when you use Dial. Coming alive. Aren't you glad you use Dial? Aren't you glad?
I kiss your hand, madame, your dainty fingertips. And while in slumberland, madame, I'm begging for your kiss. I haven't any right, madame, to do the things I do. But when I hold you tight, madame, you vanish in the night, madame. I kiss your hand, madame, and pray my dreams come true.
Again. Well, it's been so long since I had a good dinner. Lost my job, now I'm not a breadwinner. I come home to eat, and all I can see was soup.
Yeah.
Would like to have some soup here. Why should
Yeah, a mouthful of gum.
I'm the father of your country. When we drafted the Constitution, it had four more articles than it does now. Jimmy Madison even had a Bill of Wrongs to go with a Bill of Rights. Somehow we lost all that stuff. We should have had the organizer from Meade. It's a trifold binder with a perforated writing tablet, a clipboard, and six filing pockets. So get the organizer from Meade, and don't tell anyone I said the Constitution isn't all there. I cannot tell a lie. The organizer's only from Meade.
Gonna get a powerful start today. Gonna have some powerful good. Cheerio! Gonna get a powerful good feeling from Cheerios.
Toast, juice, milk, and Cheerios. Powerful good.
Once in a while, a song is written that becomes so popular that it's considered a standard. And this next tune was originally done by Louis Armstrong.
Wait a minute, man.
What?
Who did it after him?
Oh, well, let's see. Bing Crosby and the Mills Brothers did it.
And who did it after them?
Oh, Frank Sinatra and the Hoboken Four did it on Major Bowie's Amateur Hour.
Major Bowie's,
that's right.
Now, who did it after them?
Well, we did.
Yes, indeed.
And it's a thing called Shine.
Oh, yeah. Buddy, 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 day.
Cause my hair is curly.
Yes, it is.
Just because my teeth are pearly. Just because I always wear a smile.
And
like to dress up
in the latest style.
Cause I'm glad I'm living. I take these troubles all with a smile. Just because my color's shady, that's the difference, baby, why they call me on.
Yeah.
Shine, sway all bluesy.
Why don't you shine?
Yes, sir. Start with your shoes, you. Shine its blazer, make it look like new. Shine your face up, wanna see you wear a smile or two. Shine.
Oh, you're these and you're those.
Why, you'll find everything gonna turn out right fine. Folks will shine up to you. Everybody's gonna how to do 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 ya. You'll make the whole world shine.
Oh, crazy little bebop head, that's me. Cause my hair's a little curly.
Well, it says you've got curly hair.
And just because all my teeth are pearly.
My love,
little while.
Announcing new Arid XX.
Cut. Paul, just say Arid Double X.
The can says Arid.
Paul, just say Arid Double X. Roll it.
Announcing new Arid Double X, our brand new extra, extra dry Arid. Use it every day. It keeps you 50% drier than our leading spray. 50% drier. Is that true?
Cut. It's true, Paul.
I'm a nervous wreck. I could really use this Arid XX.
Double X, Paul. Arid Double X.
Suffer from a cold sore? Not when there's Anbisol.
Suffer with denture pain? No need to with Anbisol.
Let my child suffer with teething pain? Not when there's Anbisol.
Anbisol works to kill minor mouth pain on contact. Look, irritated nerve endings in the mouth. Anbisol, with three anesthetics, deadens pain immediately for hours of relief. So when denture pain, toothache, cold sores, or teething pain strikes, use Anbisol. Works to kill pain on contact.
Thank you very much. We had a real nice time this evening singing our songs for you and taking you into our world of fantasy. We'd like to wish you all a very good evening and have a nice week, and we'll see you next Sunday. Good night.
Bye-bye. So, until next Sunday, remember this.
I'm blue every Monday thinking, only on Sunday, that's one day when I'm with you. It seems that I sigh, all day Tuesday I cry, all day Wednesday, oh my, how I long for you, you. And then comes Thursday, gee, it's long, it never goes by. No Friday makes me feel like I'm gonna die. But after payday is my Monday, I shine all day Sunday, that's one day when I'm with you. And then comes Thursday, gee, it's long, it never goes by. No Friday makes me feel like I'm gonna die. But after payday is my fun day. I shine all day Sunday. That's one day when I'm with you. Wanna see you next Sunday?
This is Donald Fornig. 200 years ago today, 70 patriotic women in Newport, Rhode Island, took a newspaper ad to advertise their intentions. They would plow and hoe and rake, work their farms so men could go to war. The Newport women would not, however, shoulder muskets. That, they said, does not become our sex. In July, a British Navy man-of-war had leveled its guns on the town and threatened to destroy it. Many conservative Newporters had become converts to the patriot cause, pushed there out of fear of the British cannon. Newport's women had become militant. Not only did they pledge to do heavy work on the home front, they made a harsh demand on Newport's men. Defeat the British or die trying. I'm Donald Hornig, and that's the way it was.
These historic minutes are sponsored each night by Shell.
Get ready for Big Eddie, the most colorful character since color TV. Sheldon Leonard stars as Big Eddie starting next Saturday night right here on CBS.
You can do it. We can help. One calorie diet Pepsi can help.
You can do it. We can help. You can do it if you follow. One calorie diet Pepsi can help.
Yes, you can, if you try. One calorie diet Pepsi is one good reason why.
You can do it if you follow. One calorie diet Pepsi can help. Great tasting one calorie diet Pepsi can help.
Ever since I was a kid, my mother said, save, Stanley. So I saved my money. But these days, my wife...